Today we're going to introduce you to how to download the software tools for programming the boards in EECS 2021. So this is one of the boards. Let me see, we've got a couple of other ones. This is one of the boards I use at home, like this. And there's another one that some of you may be buying as well, it looks like this. So there's many different boards. They all work effectively the same way, and they use the same software to develop for them. So we're going to download the software, and the software is referred to as Microchip's MPLABX IDE, or Integrated Development Environment, and the XC32 compiler. You need both of these in order for the thing to work. So we're going to look for MPLABX download on Google. And here we go. Click on this. I look for MPLABX IDE on the left-hand side. And I want downloads. Again, it's one of the options on the left. Depending if you're using Windows, Linux, or Mac, there are different downloads. I'm going to be using the MPLABX IDE version 3.15 for the Mac. It was released in November of 2015. There's going to be a version as well for Windows and one for Linux. So I'm going to download the one for Mac. Now it's going to take a little bit of time for that to download, so the next thing I'm going to do is go and find the compiler, which is referred to as XC32. It's right here on the left-hand side. I'm looking for the download, which is right here. And once again, you have the option of Windows, Linux, or Mac versions. I'm going to be downloading the Mac version. And again, you'll notice that there are three different types of compilers. There's an XC8, XC16, and XC32. We have a 32-bit PIC32 MIPS processor on all of our boards, so we're going to be using the XC32 version of the compiler. Choose version 1.4 or greater, and this was released in June of 2015. So I'm going to download this as well. I'm going to wait to see for the download to finish. Now that we've downloaded the files, what we're going to do is install them. So I'm going to go and start install the MPLABX version 3.15 first. I'll double click on the installation file. It sometimes needs administrator access. So open. Yep, administrator access is required, probably both on Windows and Linux as well. Windows, Linux, and Mac. So we're going to step through here. We accept the agreement. We install in the default location. Please choose the default location, otherwise things might get messed up. We want both the integrated development environment and the integrated programming environment, both of these. You'll most likely only be using the IDE and not the IPE, but sometimes, depending on debugging scenarios, you may require the programming environment too. So we're going to install that. It will take a little bit of time. Looks like it's wrapping up. All right, So we can have the web browser load up to hint at the locations for the XC compiler, the Harmony development tools, as well as these peripheral configurations. We can go to finish like this. So code configurator, let me see. Current download. There it is. Next, Harmony. Search, search, search. Ah, there we go, downloads, right there. And XC32, which we've already done, but we'll just do it again here. Downloads, I want Max, or the Mac version, MPLAB XC32. Click on that. Okay, so I'm not going to show you how to do the code configurator or Harmony. I'll leave that up to you later. What we really need to do right now is to get the compiler installed. So I'm going to go back here and click on the already downloaded version of the compiler, which is XC32. Actually, you can see it right here. XC32 full install. Double click on that. And double click on it here. It'll be very similar under Windows, for instance. Oh, and it doesn't let me. So what I have to do is right click on it, open, because on Mac there's a sandboxing system in place. I go open like that. Type in my password. There we go. Get yourself a coffee. We agree. We wait, a lot of waiting. These are relatively big pieces of software, so it takes a while. So make sure you've got your coffee. Still not letting me accept. I'll wait some more. Drink my coffee. Oh, thank you. We're now ready to proceed. We want the free version. All right. The free version is good because it costs no money. You want to install it in the default installation directory. It will be different under Mac and Windows. Choose the default. And yes, I want to add XC32 to the path environment variable. That helps find the compiler when developing your code. Setup is now ready to begin installing the compiler. We go next. Again, take your coffee out. It's going to take a little while. So I'm going to pause the recording for the time being. I'll come back in a little bit. So what we see now is that the XC32 compiler has been installed. And there's some options on here that I've never had to click on. And it says what my host ID is. I go next. You might want to record that host ID for future use. Setup has finished the requested actions for MPLAB XC32 compiler on your computer. That's great. And so that's now all installed. Okay, so If I go to my applications directory, I should be able to find a microchip folder. There it is right there. I have MPLABX version 3.15. I'm going to take that, I'm going to drag it onto my dock, put it where your shortcuts are going to be, and there we go. I click on it. And up should come MPLABX. No, I'm not going to import settings from previously. I had a different version of MPLABX on my computer before, but that's from a few years back. Going with a brand new version. It's going to load up. Okay, so here we go. We have MPLABX IDE version 3.15. We are now ready to create a new project. So I'm going to do that very, very quickly. I'll go like this, File, New Project, Microchip Embedded, Standalone Project. Click, click, click. Okay. Whoops, I clicked once too many times. I go back. All families, no, I don't want all families of chips. I want the chips that are found actually on this board or, oops, shouldn't be dropping them so much, or this board right here. And these are PIC32s. They're 32-bit processors, and we can find one right there. I'm going to choose, let me see, I'm going to scroll through. I took a look on the chip itself before, and it was a PIC32MX250F128B, this one right here. I'm going to click on Next. At this point, I'm just going to choose the simulator. And I'm going to choose XE32 version 1.4. I had 1.32 on there before, but I'm not going to use it. So I'm going to use XE32 version 1.40, which is what we just downloaded. I'm going to call this my first project. I say finish. And make sure that it's been set to my main project, because you can have multiple projects going on at the same time. And over here you see that we've now got project files associated with my first project, and we're going to make files within the source file directory. I'm going to right click on this, I'm going to say new, xc32newfile.c, or maybe I'll try other. How about that? Other. C. Oh, this is better. C. C main file, like this. It'll be called new main. Type in finish. Again, it's nice to have a little bit of coffee nearby when you need to wait for things to happen. So I grab my coffee, drink some coffee, or tea, or hot chocolate. Looks like I'd have enough time to make some more coffee as well. There we go. All right, so it has generated a main function. And if I go like this, I'm going to type in one more here, include xc.h, because it's one of those files that you're always going to use. I go to the hammer and broom, so clean and build. At the bottom of the screen, it tells you that the compiler has compiled or is in the process of compiling the file. Actually, it says loading is completed. We're good to go. And there you go. We've now set up the entire integrated development environment. We've tested out a little bit of simple code, and we're ready to proceed on with the course.